No, conjugation here we have, but this ring is not in conjugation. So aromaticity is only for ring, cyclic planar ring compound, conjugated ring. Which this one? Yes. Which one? How many pi electrons we have here? See, this lone pair can form a pi bond because the vacant orbitals, it can donate into the vacant orbital. So we have 3 pi bond here, so it is 6 pi electron and it is aromatic. This compound we call it as inorganic benzene.
So what is inorganic?
Formula is B3N3H6. We also call it as borazole. Okay, what about this molecule? 2, 4, 6, and it is in conjugation. So it is 6 pi electron.
Aromatic.
Okay, what about this one? 4, 6, 8. Anti-aromatic. Okay, but this one is not anti-aromatic, this one is non-aromatic. See, whenever the cyclic compound has 7 or more atom present, okay, 7 or more atom present, then it cannot be anti-aromatic. Aromatic possible, anti-aromatic is not possible. Because anti-aromatic compounds are highly unstable compounds. So in case of this case, the molecule changes its plane and becomes non-aromatic.
Right?
No. What I am telling you, if the ring has more 7 or more atom present, okay, then aromatic is possible. Like you see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbon atom. Aromatic, fine. But anti-aromatic is not possible because it is highly unstable. This molecule will change its plane and it becomes non-planar. And non-planar compound is what? It can be non. That's what I said. This is experimental.
So how many exceptions?
I told you this thing, that basic thing is what? Huckel-Stroh conjugation and all. But there are many compounds in which different cases we have. That's why we are doing all these examples. Okay? So you have to keep this in mind. When the molecule has, write down this one, the last one, write down. When the molecule has 7 or more atom present, cyclic molecule, okay? 7 or more atom present. When the molecule has 7 or more atom present, it will never be anti-aromatic because it is highly unstable, comma, the molecule changes its plane and becomes non-aromatic. Vacant pure orbital.
So by changes its plane, do you mean that like folds?
It's like this part is in other plane and this part is in other plane. It's like, okay, so overall the molecule becomes non-plane.
Seven atoms is the main chain.
Seven atoms. Cyclic only we are considering, not total. Side chain we won't consider. Okay? So overall what we can say, 7 atom is present, then aromatic possible, anti-aromatic is not possible. So only 2 answers possible in this case, aromatic or non-aromatic. Okay, if it has 4n plus 2 pi electron, aromatic, otherwise it will be non-aromatic. Anti-aromatic won't possible here. One more thing you see here, this pyridine has this lone pair available, and pyrrole, this lone pair is in conjugation with this pi bond, right? It means, in other words, what we can say, this lone pair is available on this nitrogen atom, but this lone pair is involved in resonance. It is delocalized. This lone pair is delocalized, and this lone pair is localized. Localized means present on the atom. Okay? That term we use for this. This lone pair is localized, this is delocalized. So if you have to compare the basicity of these two molecules, pyridine and pyrrole. Pyridine, the lone pair is available, so it can donate lone pair. That's what the basic nature. So basicity of pyridine is more than to that of pyrrole. Because this lone pair is delocalized, so it is not available. It cannot donate. So basicity decreases. Right? Right now, the basicity of pyridine is more than to that of pyrrole. Since the lone pair on nitrogen atom, in case of pyridine is available. What about this one? This one is non-aromatic, because 7 atoms are there, and 2, 4, 6, 8 pi electron, right? So according to that, it should be anti-aromatic. Since we have we have 7 atoms, so this convert into non-aromatic. Anti-aromatic, not possible. What about this one?
Aromatic.
Oh, it is aromatic. This is also non-aromatic. This is sp3 hybridized. Conjugation is not there. You count this lone pair. But this is what? sp3 hybridized. Okay? This one is.
Why is it sp3?
It will have a hydrogen.
So for aromatic, there cannot be any sp3.
Zero conjugation you have to check. You see, we have conjugation till here. This part is not in conjugation.
That's right.
So the one is non-aromatic.
This one is
non-aromatic, yeah. So why? Because one carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. This entire thing is not in conjugation. sp3 agar hai, to non-aromatic. Logic is what? Because we have conjugation till here, right? Till here. But this part is not in conjugation. That's why it is non-aromatic. This one? Now, because of this positive charge, the entire thing becomes sp conjugation. So it has 6 pi electron.
Aromatic.
Wait, so but the what is the positive charge? Oh, it means that it's sp.
It's sp2 and it is in conjugation. Lone pair sigma vacant p.
No, so why is that sp2? Because there is only one hydrogen bond.
1, 2, 3. 3 sigma bond.
Sir, what exactly does the last charge
The hydrogen is not there.
See, plus charge means, the first of all, this now this becomes in conjugation. Because lone pair sigma begin P. Right? So this is in conjugation, that's why they can't teach it as well. Okay? What about this one? There's no charge here, but boron has vacant orbital. This is again is in conjugation. 6 pi electron aromatic. Write down aromaticity in case of multicyclic compound. More than one cyclic structure. I'll write down some structure here. More than one cyclic structure. I'll draw some structures. Okay? Multicyclic compound. Write down, in this case we only count, in this case we only count the peripheral pi bond or pi electrons. In this case we only count the peripheral pi electrons. Okay? For example, you see this one.
SP3
is not possible. Middle and SP3 possible only. That is one, that's not possible. See, in this case, we'll count only peripheral pi electrons. Right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 pi electron means 10 pi electron. 10 electrons means what? 4N plus 2, it is aromatic. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 12 pi electron. This is what?
Anti-aromatic.
Okay? This one you see, we only count peripheral pi electrons.
That's not possible.
This one is non-peripheral pi bond. And hence we won't count this. Okay? So we have only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 14 pi electron. And it is aromatic.
So what do you mean by non?
Non-peripheral means this is non-peripheral pi electron. Across this boundary you have to go. Okay. The common bond between the rings, okay, this including this two ring or this bond which we have. Means only what you have to do, you have to follow this bond. Only this bond. This bond we won't consider. Okay? Non-peripheral pi bond, we won't count in this. One more thing you see, if you have a molecule like this, okay. Write down in this one note first. We'll see the. Copy down this one. Write down multicyclic compounds. Multicyclic compound will be either aromatic or anti-aromatic. Either aromatic or anti-aromatic. Non-aromatic is not possible here. Okay? So when you look at this structure, right, this structure, this carbon atom is what?
sp3
hybridized. So that's why this becomes what? Non-aromatic. But like I said, it cannot be non-aromatic here, right? Then what we'll do, the larger ring is this, correct? Then we'll check the next smaller ring into this, which is nothing but this one. Two rings we have here, one is this, another one is this, so this molecule forms. Okay, so the larger ring we'll see first. If it is non-aromatic, we'll check the next smaller ring. If again you'll get non-aromatic, we'll check another next smaller ring till we get aromatic or anti-aromatic compound.
Wait, so but then in this resonation is not possible, right? Like
where?
In the rectangle one.
Yeah, in this one it is not possible. But here it is possible.
So it will just bypass.
And because of this only, the molecule is highly stable here. So you see,
bypasses the
see. In aromaticity, still the research is going on. We are only the Huckel's rule is not the correct thing, because I have given you many examples where Huckel's rule is not possible and it is aromatic or anti-aromatic compounds. So in this section, you have to keep these examples in mind. This compound is highly stable compound, okay? And that's why I'm giving you this point-wise, multi-cyclic compound, what you have to do. That's what you have to keep in mind. Like I said, it cannot be non-aromatic. And how do you know that molecule is aromatic or anti-aromatic? So first we'll check the larger ring, right? It is non-aromatic, not possible. Then we'll check the next smaller ring. If it is non-aromatic, again we'll check the next smaller ring till we get aromatic or anti-aromatic compound. Like for this one, you see, this compound is sp3 non-aromatic. The next smaller ring is this. This one is aromatic. It means the entire compound is aromatic.
So we see the next smaller ring.
Yes.
First ring.
Yes. If that is non-aromatic, we'll check the next smaller ring. Then again, next smaller ring. Like for example, this one you see. This one.
Wait, sir. When we check the rectangle, what we take it as it has two double bonds.
Yes.
Sir, I don't think we have to check.
See, first of all, this one is non-aromatic. The next ring is what?
Anti-aromatic.
Yeah.
This is also non-aromatic.
You said like smaller ring, right?
So yeah, after this, we have this.
We check that it's non-aromatic.
And then the next one is this.
Anti.
This is anti-aromatic. And this means the entire compound is what?
Anti-aromatic. So what if that one also was non-aromatic?
Then we'll again check the smaller one, which is not possible. Still we get aromatic or anti-aromatic.
No, sir, but like what if it was only this and that turned out to be non-aromatic?
That is not possible, you won't get this kind of compound, but you have to go till you get anti-aromatic or aromatic.
When it is non-aromatic,
then we have to go this way.
Okay. So
if it is this way,
when you split it, you can count that.
Yes, you can count this pi electron with this also and with this also.
So aromatic and
anti-aromatic. Done? Okay, one comparison we'll do. The last example. This bond is alpha, this bond is beta. You have to compare the bond order of alpha and bond order of beta, and then bond length also. That's clear. Why?
Not yet. Yeah.
Yeah. What is aromatic?
The second one is aromatic.
First one is non-aromatic.
You see, in this compound, we can shift this pi electron either on this ring or on this ring, right? Because both are in conjugation. Pi, sigma, pi, right? So we can shift both way, right? So if you shift this pi electron onto this carbon, then what happens, you see? We are just drawing the resonating structure. This becomes negative and this becomes positive. Lone pair on it. This to pi bond. Okay? And here, if you shift this here, this is positive and this is negative. Okay? Now, because of this shifting, you see, this ring is what? Aromatic. Pi sigma 2, 4, 6. Aromatic. And this is what? Also aromatic. Both rings are aromatic here. This ring is what? And this ring is what?
Aromatic.
So if you compare this two, this compound is more stable than this. It means this shifting is what? Easier than this shifting. Right? It means this bond order here is close to 1 and here it is close to 2. Right? So bond order of alpha is less than the bond order.
Wait, sir. In that one, the B compound, we had to
determine
if it was anti-aromatic or aromatic.
Which one? This one?
Yeah. Because you said you should pick the larger ring. But I'm not
looking at
the same here.
Also, if you shift here also, you get the same compound. That won't change. If you shift this here, this ring becomes anti-aromatic. This ring becomes aromatic. Why this shifting is there? Because according to this, it is getting aromaticity, stability. So that's why this shifting will be possible.
So shouldn't the greater stability imply that it's a bond order?
Greater what?
Greater the stability, greater the bond order.
No, bond order is not for molecule. It's for the bond between the two atoms in a molecule.
Yeah, but like greater the stability.
No. See, this bond order is 2 here. What is the bond order here? 1. If this is more stable, it means this molecule wants to be in this form. Means bond order is closer to 1 here. Right? Here bond order is 2. Bond order is 1, but this one is less stable than this. That's why this molecule wants to be in this form. Right? The bond order is closer to 2. That's how we'll do the comparison. Huh?
In that second stage, one of them is anti-aromatic and one is aromatic. So is the whole molecule anti-aromatic?
No, we can say, we cannot talk about the whole molecule here. We say this part is aromatic, anti-aromatic, this part is aromatic. So the whole molecule won't have the stability as aromatic compounds or anti-aromatic. It will be somewhere in this field. We cannot say.
So this term is
possible, you can draw this, but This is stated as aromatic.
So how do you say that is more stable than that bottom right?
This one?
That's more stable than that.
No, this is actually, see, the half part is aromatic, anti-aromatic. We are not comparing the stability of this two. We are comparing the stability of this two. Right? This one, the both part is aromatic. It means this has more tendency to convert into this form. Because you are getting stability here, aromatic compound, to convert into this. But this has less tendency to convert into this because this is anti-aromatic. That's why the bond order here is close to 2 and here it is close to 1. Okay? Understood?
Sir, make the bond go there. Make the bond go there, right? Make it go right. They won't be different.
This one. Both become anti-aromatic now. That's why this conversion is not possible. If you have this option, then this will go towards stability now. Why this will form anti-aromatic compound? This won't form. Right?
So in general, doesn't it say that if something has a bond order that's high, its stability higher or lower?
Bond order is high, stability will be more of that bond.
So here we're saying stability.
No. See, again you're taking me wrong. I'm not talking about the stability of this bond. I'm talking about the stability of entire molecule. This is more stable than this.
Yeah.
Than this, right?
Yeah.
So this molecule has tendency to exist in this form.
Yeah.
Right? This molecule has lesser tendency to exist in this form in comparison to this. So when this molecule exists in this form, here the bond order is what? One. So we can say, since this is more stable than this, so here the bond order is closer to one. And this is only more stable than this. So bond order is closer to two. That's why bond order of beta is more than to that of alpha. Bond length will be what? Reverse. Okay. That's why from this to this is not possible. Because it's highly unstable now. Both becomes anti-aromatic.
Yeah.
So stable over here. That's why this will form. Okay? Okay.